I realized I wanted to become an engineer from when I was actually very young. My dad was a farmer, and I used to do work from time to time with my dad, where we would work on different machinery, we would work on things. I'm thinking back to my days when I was in high school. I used to tutor students all the time, and that was also something which was a very rewarding experience. I love working one-on-one with students. I'm very, very proud of all of my students, and watching them grow and develop, and just thinking about how just 2 years ago, they wouldn't have been able to do what they're able to do today. The work that you do directly with them enables them to be able to do the great things that they're going to go out and do in the world. That's probably what I'm most proud of.
Amy is a really hard worker. She really motivates me to come in early and to like work as hard as I can. I try to take her same approach that if I work hard, the students who I'm working with will also work hard, and then we'll together achieve something that we couldn't have done individually.
And our new float switch and valve is working pretty well.
What I appreciate about working in the area of international development is the potential impacts of the work that you can do. There are almost 1 billion people out there without access to clean drinking water. There are 1.3 billion people that don't have access to a reliable source of electricity. Be able to develop technologies that can touch even just a portion of those people can potentially have this enormous impact on their quality of life.
What's particularly rewarding about working in Amy's lab is because so much of her research has a very high impact. So the people that you're targeting with your research, they can benefit so much more than if you're working with something that's a lot more theoretical. And you get that instant gratification in that research, which stays with you for a long time.
Some of the work we've been doing through the capstone projects here at the University of Toronto is being done with this organization called Winds of Change. And it's being done with a community in Nicaragua called Pedro Arauz. In that community, we've actually been looking at being able to help develop technologies which can provide methods for them to be able to grow crops year-round. Right now, they've only been able to grow crops during the rainy season, and it severely limits the amount of income that the farmers in these communities can make. So we've been looking at working with them to help develop sustainable agricultural technologies to be able to pump water for irrigation and apply that water for irrigation in a very efficient way. I also do some work with Professional Engineers of Ontario, PEO. I've done several guest talks for the PEO, talking about some of the work that we're doing here on campus and letting them know what's going on. I'm a member of the Canadian Society for Mechanical Engineers. I put together articles which actually go into the CSME bulletin to provide research updates on what's going on in different universities around Canada. The U of T has a lot of STEM outreach, which is excellent. It's one of those ways that high school students get to understand what goes on in engineering, why is it an exciting profession, and is it something where they could see themselves potentially taking part in and contributing in as they grow and develop. As a woman in engineering, I also think it's really important for young female students to understand and see that, you know, women can be very successful in the field of engineering and be able to have role models that they can look up to as they go forward in their careers. The biggest piece of advice that I give to my graduate students is to not settle. Always be looking for that opportunity, and not just to settle into something because it's comfortable, but really push yourself through.